but a couple of arrow stickers there. Can you read that out?
Crowds of women rejoicing at the news from Munich cheered Mrs. Neville Chamberlain for several minutes last night as she left St. Michael's Church, Chester Square, London, where the Archbishop of Canterbury had addressed a broadcast service. As Mrs. Chamberlain appeared at one of the doors after the service, a great crowd were waiting to cheer her. By the time her car had arrived, they had grown to several thousands. As she stepped into the car, they surged round her, cheering continuously.
Oh, interestingly, the first thing you went to was an image of a car.
It really was,
with
yeah.
With loads of people around it. I'm so important I hadn't told you that story.
Not at all,
I hadn't told you
no.
What happened. Listen, I'm going to stop there, but thank you right. Very, very much. That's fantastic, really interesting. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
I wasn't enjoying being amongst those people. I was quite glad when I was told to go back into the hotel corridor again. That felt like a relief. I think probably the scientific logic of it would indicate that Derren's a witch. I'm happy to go with that.
After going backwards in time, I want to move on to the more philosophically interesting area of travelling forward in time. And to do that, David's going to have to pretend to read someone's mind. I'm going to have you project yourself forward in time, 20 minutes, and tell me something that's going to happen.
Right.
All right. Let me take your arm. Just relax, look at me, put your feet flat on the floor. In a little while, we're going to leave here, we're going to walk out onto the street. You're going to go up to somebody in the street, and you're going to have them draw a picture. And you can choose anybody you like. Now, what you're then going to do is to pretend to read their mind. And what I want you to do in a second is to project yourself forward to the point that at the end of that trick, they will turn their drawing around and show you what they've drawn, okay? And I want you to see in the future what it is that they're going to draw. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Now close your eyes for me. I'm going to put your hand up there. That hand will not come down any more quickly or slowly than it takes you to begin to get a sense of what that is. You don't have to think about it, but you're just imagining them with that drawing. You can see in your mind whether it's a man or a woman. You've pretended to read the mind. You get it right. And then they turn it around. And at the point your hand touches the table, you'll have a clear sense of what it is. Just open your eyes for me. Remember what that is. I'd like you now to go and stand in the corner, just behind you. You can then draw what you're thinking of. I will not look. So stand there with the wall behind you, facing into the room, so you know nothing. You look over your shoulder, and I look over here. Nice and large and clear. When you're done, just fold it up, put it straight in your pocket, and please, no cameras directly on that. When you've done it, don't show anybody. Fold it straight up, put it in your pocket. Lovely. Done that?
Mm-hmm.
Excellent. Let's go. There should still be some people around. It's 20 to 4.
Thanks very much.
Thank you. Let's go.
This is quite odd. I am quite freaked out by this.
David's now going to act out the mind reading he imagined 20 minutes ago to see if a random member of the public will draw what he foresaw that they would.
What sort of person should I be looking for?
Entirely up to you.
I have a blank canvas.
A blank canvas?
Let's do it. Maybe down here?
Yes.
No.
No?
I'm not feeling a psychic bond.
Okay.
There's someone. We're not rolling. Are we rolling? Excuse me. You don't have 5 minutes to let me try and read your mind, do you?
I'd love you to.
Would you? Brilliant. I found someone. What's your name?
Claire.
Claire, I'm David. It's lovely to meet you. This is Derren.
Hello, I'm Derren.
He's a sort of witch. Don't worry about that.
Excellent. Come up here and we'll put a microphone on you and we'll, yes. And we'll do
David's
that.
David's going to read your mind. I'm going to stand you there facing David.
Okay.
And David there facing
yeah.
Claire.
Yeah.
Good. Now, this is very simple. I've been teaching David some of my mind reading skills, and he is in a moment going to read your mind as you focus on a picture or an image or something. Now, I need you to start doing that now. All I'd say is, as you do it, make the image very clear, very bright, very vivid. Try not to change it and mess it around. If you happen to be thinking of like a house or a stick man, change it, think of something else. Now I'm going to ask you to draw this before
okay.
We do anything. David, you obviously mustn't look at what Claire draws.
No,
so
cool.
Just get a pen and paper. Nice and large and clear, please. David, look the other way. And you also, as you can't tell from the sound of the pen or anything.
I can't hear anything.
You can't even hear anything now. I can, I've got quite good at this. But no idea.
Okay, I've got
done.
It.
Done, just hold the whole thing up against yourself. Right, can David turn back round now? Lovely. Oh, well, you don't dip dirty fingers. Lovely.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Here we go. So, Claire, You're focusing on the image. Now start sending that picture across, and at the same time, in your mind, just scream the name of the thing over and over again. Make that image clear, really big and bold and bright. Now, David, as you're doing this, are you getting a sense of animal, vegetable, or mineral?
I think it's living. I think it's a living thing.
All right. Now, don't say yes or no, but you've given away probably a nice yes then from that.
And I think it's a furry animal, like a pet, and it's yeah. I think I know what it is. I think it's a cat.
Now, is it?
This is the worst drawing ever, but it definitely is a cat.
That's really good. Well done.
Really good. It's appalling. That's I'm supposed to be an art student.
It's not. Claire's a fine art student.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. What year?
Congratulations.
Thank
We're going to ask you a few
much.
Questions about it, so just stay put for a second.
Okay.
Well done, though. Congratulations. Let's step out.
I can't understand possibly at all how he would have been able to grab that from me. Well, it was pretty strange when he said that he thought it was something furry. It was quite difficult for me not to laugh, actually, just because I couldn't believe he'd actually got it.
So this is Claire's drawing, which is quite freaky. Well, I'm just going to show you, because I'm really quite freaked out by this. There's not much to choose between them, really. It's the tail's going the same way, even the sort of slightly devilish, the devil horn ears, which as I drew them, I was thinking, they don't look much like cat ears, but she's done exactly the same thing.
But I wasn't expecting it to be quite so bang on.
Now that I've shown David that his own abilities can place him backwards or forwards in time, I try one final game with him. I want David to try and predict a future event that will appear in his daily newspaper, The Guardian, and for this, he's going to try some automatic writing, whereby he can let his subconscious mind express itself without rational interference. I need him to be as relaxed as possible, so to combine this with the opportunity of seeing David in a close-fitting wetsuit, I've decided to give him the experience of a flotation tank. For 45 minutes, David relaxes and relaxes and slowly enters an altered state of consciousness. When he seems most receptive, he's gently helped out of the pool, maintaining an optimum trance state in order to write his prediction. I want you to, first of all, sign your name at the top of this piece of paper. I shall dictate if you can write. My name is David Tennant. I am now about to begin automatic writing.